Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Sumi Learns Chinese. 大家好，欢迎来到我的频道 Sumi 学中文。Today we are going to learn more daily conversation about pet. If you are pet lovers, then congratulations because we're going to learn more phrases and sentence structure to express your feeling about having pets. 大家好。今天我们将会学习更多有关于养宠物的一些日常会话。如果你是宠物的主人们，那么恭喜你了，你将会知道更多的一些字词，去跟别人去分享一下你家可爱的小宠物了。那么事不宜迟，就让我们现在开始吧。今天我们将会学习日常会话，宠物上。来，一起读一次。日常 means daily，绘画 conversation，日常绘画 daily conversation。宠物，宠物 pet，上 means part one。来，一起把这句话读一次。日常绘画，宠物上。Number one, we are going to learn I have or I keep. 我养了，我养了，我 I 养 have or keep, but literally. It means feed or raise. Okay, 养了，养了，来一起读一次。我养了，我养了。One more time. 我养了，我养了一只狗。I have a dog. 我养了一只狗，狗，dog，狗，dog。我养了一只狗。So beware of the e. Actually, the e has different pronunciation with different meanings. But in this case, we have to pronounce it as the fourth tone. It should be E. E. 一只狗. 来,一起读一次. 一只狗. Remember, it is the fourth tone, okay? 一只狗. 来,整句话读一次. 我养了一只狗. Okay, quickly, let's see if we can read it faster, okay? 我养了一只狗。我养了一只狗。Well done. It's very good that you can read it faster, okay? Let's keep going. 我养了两只猫。我养了两只猫。I have two cats, or I keep two cats. 猫 cat 来,一起读一次。猫猫猫。对了，非常好，千万别读成妈，好吗？妈 is a question word or it is 妈妈。Okay, it is mom. So beware of your pronunciation. You should be 猫。猫，对了，猫。The sentence is 我养了两只猫。我养了两只猫。So let me see if there is any Sumi learners spot something different. Actually, 两 means two. I think some Sumi learner may have a brief idea about numbering, right? So we are counting One, two, three, four. In Chinese, we may say 一、二、三、四. So we are counting number two, we say 二、二. But when we are describing we have two dogs or two cats, we will say 两只,两只, not 二只. 二只 is very weird. We will say 两只,两只. Okay, 只 is measure word. If actually it can be changed to 个,条. Okay, but 两 we should pay more attention to. Okay, 两. Like, let's read the whole sentence together. 我养了两只猫。我养了两只猫。猫, okay, let's see if we can read it faster. 我养了两只猫。我养了两只猫。Faster. 我养了两只猫. That's good. So I wish when you are reading this sentence, you can read it faster because when we are talking about our favorite cat, we will be excited, right? So when we are excited, we will speed up. So 我养了两只猫。我养了两只猫. Well done. Let's keep going. Well, could you see? It's a very cute rabbit, right? So we may say 我养了三只兔子. Is there any Sumi learner understand what is 三只兔子? Do you know that? Yes, it is three rabbits. Okay, I have three rabbits. 我养了三只兔子. 兔子 is rabbit. 兔子. 兔子, 兔子, 对了, 三, 三, 只, 只, 兔子, 三只兔子. Okay, there is something Sumi Warner remind all of you because in Mandarin Chinese we have to pay attention to the measure word because compared with English, we seldom use measure word, but in Chinese, we have lot of different kinds of measure word when we're describing different animals and different objects. So we have to pay attention to this case. When we're describing 兔子, we should use 只. And also, what about 狗 and 猫? Do you remember? I give you 3 seconds. Yes, it is 知 too, okay? 知 too. 来,一起读这个句子,再读一次. 我养了三只兔子。我养了三只兔子。Oh, this time I have four goldfish. I have four goldfish. 我养了四条鱼。我养了四条金鱼。Specific one, okay? 金鱼 is goldfish. 鱼 is fish, okay? 鱼, fish. 金, it is gold. So combine it together, which is 金鱼. 金鱼. 来,一起读一次. 金鱼. Okay, you sure when you are pronouncing 鱼, remember, you have to level up your voice, okay? 金鱼,金鱼, very good. 我养了四条金鱼, okay? 四 is four, okay? 我养了四条金鱼. In this case, the measure word is 条,条, okay? 我养了四条金鱼. Let's read it one more time. 我养了四条金鱼。我养了四条金鱼。That's good. Okay, secondly, we are going to learn 我领养了。I adopt. I know some of Suming learners, they are full of love, they're very caring, so they would like to adopt the pet instead of buying. So in this case, we may say 我领养了, 领养, adopt, 领养了. Okay, remember, 领养都是 后鼻音, 后鼻音 means they have G, okay? Okay, they have G. So when you see G, as the pinyin, then you have to be careful. You have to beware of your tongue. You should be liang, yang. Okay, with your open your mouth. Okay, as big as you can. Liang yang. Okay, wo liang yang la. Okay, wo liang yang la. 我领养了5只粘人的大狗. I adopt 5 big and clingy dogs. Okay, 我领养了5只粘人的大狗. 领养了, 领养了, 大狗. 大狗 means big dog. 狗, go is dog. 来一起读一次. 大狗, 大狗, okay. This one, 粘人的, 粘人的, which is clingy, clingy, 粘人的. Okay, let's read these five characters together. Okay, 粘人的大狗, 粘人的大狗. Okay, in this episode, we will focus on the animal. And in the upcoming episode, we will pay more attention to the adjective and the measure word. So maybe we may have a brief idea about what is adjective and what is measure word in this episode too. Okay? 我领养了5只粘人的大狗。来，一起读一次。我领养了五只粘人的大狗。来，快一点，Let's read it faster。我领养了五只粘人的大狗。OK，Let's read it faster。我领养了五只粘人的大狗。It's your turn。It's good. It's very good. Okay, so be more confident. Read aloud. Okay, read aloud. If you practice more, your Chinese could be improved. So don't hesitate and don't be shy. Okay, 我领养了5只粘人的大狗. Very good. Next one. I adopt 6 cute squirrels. 我领养了6只可爱的小松鼠. Okay. 松鼠 is squirrels, okay? 松鼠，小 is small or little. I adopt 6 cute or small, squirrels, okay? 小松鼠，来一起读一次。小松鼠，松鼠，松鼠，okay? What about the little squirrels? It could be 小松鼠，小松鼠，OK，可爱的 is cute，可爱的，OK，Let's read the whole sentence together。我领养了六只可爱的小松鼠，我领养了六只可爱的小松鼠，Let's read it faster。我领养了六只可爱的小松鼠，我领养了六只可爱的小松鼠。Well done! You see, the 小松鼠 is looking at us. It's like, wow, please adopt me. 快点来领养我吧！来，小松鼠。Oh, next one. I adopt 7 energetic hamsters. 我领养了7只活泼的仓鼠，仓鼠，hamster，hamster，hamster, 仓鼠，OK，我领养了7只活泼的仓鼠 Maybe in this case, I help Sumi learners pay attention to the plurals, okay? In Mandarin Chinese, we seldom say 仓鼠, okay? We will have general speaking is 仓鼠. No matter one hamster, two hamster, or three hamster, no matter one dog, two dog, or three dogs, we will only have one single form, which is 仓鼠, 狗, or 猫, okay? I hope you can notice it, okay? 仓鼠. 活泼的 is energetic. Energetic. 活泼的, 来,一起读一次, 活泼的, 活泼的, 仓鼠, 仓鼠, okay? Let's read the whole sentence together, okay? 我养了七只活泼的仓鼠, 我养了七只活泼的仓鼠, okay? Do you guys love 仓鼠? I remember one of my students who loves hamsters so much. And then he named 仓鼠 with lot of cute name. So if I have chance, maybe I will share with you guys next time, okay? 我领养了七只活泼的仓鼠. Next one. I adopt 8 naughty kittens. 我领养了八只 调皮的小猫, 来一起读一次, 小猫, 小猫. Whenever you see 小, that means it is tiny, or it is little, or it's just a baby, okay? 小, 小猫, 调皮的, naughty, 调皮的, naughty, 八只, eight, 八只, eight, okay? 来一起读一次, 我领养了八只调皮的小猫, 我领养了八只调皮的小猫, okay? Let's read it one more time faster. 我领养了八只调皮的小猫, 我领养了八只调皮的小猫. Well done! Keep going, okay? I enjoy and I'm very happy to hear your voice when you are reading aloud. That's very good. Okay, keep going. Keep going. Okay, thirdly, we're going to learn more about 动物, animals. Do you remember we have learned in the first slide? First slide, it is 狗, 狗, dog, 狗, okay? 小狗, little dog, we will say 小狗, big dog. 大狗. What about a puppy? 我们也会说小狗, okay? 小狗. Okay, I want to ask you a question. How do we say big dog? Gigantic dog? Yes, we're going to say 大狗, okay? 大狗. Next one is 猫, meow, okay? 猫, okay? 小猫, little kitten. 大猫, 大猫 is the big cat, okay? 猫, 猫. Next one, 兔子, rabbit, 兔子, rabbit. Okay, let's 一起读一次, 兔子, 兔子, okay? Rabbit. Next one, 金鱼, goldfish. 金鱼, goldfish. 金鱼, goldfish, okay? Do you love having 金鱼? Okay, I know that there are different types of fish, especially the goldfish. Some goldfish are big, some goldfish are small, and they're colorful. So if Sumi, you're the expert of having the goldfish, maybe you can let me know what is the difference about different types of goldfish, okay? 如果你们都是金鱼的专家的话, 那么不妨就是让Sumi知道一下到底金鱼它是不是有不同的品种呢? 然后颜色是不是也不一样呢? 也可以在下面留言跟大家分享一下。 Okay, next one, 松鼠, 松鼠，OK，松鼠，来读一次，松鼠。Remember, the 鼠 is going down first and then go up. 鼠，鼠，OK，松鼠，squirrel，OK，小松鼠就是 little squirrel. Do you know that actually 松鼠 keep eating every day? So I remember. A lot of my close friends and they would like to call me 松鼠 because I always eat. Okay, I love eating, so they give me a nickname called 松鼠. So you can see that actually, when you have close relationship with your friend, sometimes we will give them a nickname as the of animal's name. Okay, like 松鼠. Okay, like 可爱的小猪. Okay, next one, 仓鼠. 来一起读一次，仓鼠，仓鼠。Do you see that? There is a G, okay? G. So remember, open your mouth as wide as you could. 仓鼠，仓鼠。It's hamster, hamster. Today we have learned lots of vocabularies and sentence structured about pet. So let's go through what we have learned today. Firstly, 我养了, I have or I keep. Okay, let me ask you a question, okay, Simi learners. What if I want to say, I have dog, I have three dogs, I have three dogs in Chinese? What could we say in Chinese? I will give you 3 seconds. 我养了三只狗，狗，OK。What about I have rabbit? I have rabbit。我养了兔子，我养了兔子，OK。So next one, OK。The sentence structure we have learned, which is 我领养了，领养 means adopt, okay? Instead of buying, okay? You emphasize that you adopt the animal, okay? It should be 领养，领养，领养，okay? 我领养了，okay? What could I say? 我 I have hamsters. I have hamster. I have hamster in Chinese. It is 我领养了仓鼠，我领养了仓鼠。Okay, so thirdly, which is 动物，we have learned lots of 动物's name. Okay, like 金鱼、兔子、松鼠、狗。猫，and what else? Is anyone remember? Is it 金鱼？What else we have learned? If you know it and you still remember, please comment below and let Sumi know that you actually pay attention to the lesson, okay? In the end of our lesson, I would like to have a question, okay? It is a Q&A section. Do you have any pet? 你家有宠物吗？你家有宠物吗？So when we are talking with others, we want to start a conversation. We may ask the same question too. 你家有宠物吗？Do you have any pet? If yes, what kind of pet do you have? 如果有的话，你家养了什么宠物呢？如果有的话，你家养了什么宠物呢？If no, what kind of pet do you want to have? 如果没有的话，你想养什么宠物呢？So if you have any ideas, don't hesitate to comment below and let Sumi know. Do you have any pet? And what kind of pet do you have? or what kind of pet you want to have, okay? Today, we have learned lots of phrases and sentence structures about having pet. If you like it and you find it interesting and useful, don't hesitate to like, subscribe my channel, and comment below, and also share my video to your friends, which you think it is very useful to them. And last but not least, all the key points from this video is uploaded to my IG, Sumi Learns Chinese too. If you want to get the keynote, don't hesitate to follow my IG too. So see you next time. Bye.